If you go to Coco Bongo, don't bother getting this. The gold membership, it means absolutely jack. Coco Bongo, don't bother getting this. The gold membership, it means absolutely jack shit. You get nothing, nothing extra. You get put up in a corner and you're still expected to pay $120 tip per person to be seated somewhere better when, you know, you're supposed to get better seats anyway. That's why you're a bloody gold member. That's why you pay the extra money. Absolute load of crap. Don't even bother going there. Just don't.
Hi guys, so I just wanted to add a little something extra to the end of the video just to explain a few more things, because at the time I wasn't having a great time. I didn't film a lot and I definitely didn't speak enough in the videos at all, and as you can see from the clips, I've just put little bits of wording at the bottom, and you know, it wasn't quite enough to get our point across. So basically we have the gold membership tickets, and you pay extra for those so you have better seats. So what it was, we had seats upon the balcony, so it's sort of away from all the crowds, down on the floor, better view of the stage, and also a quick entry, so we go to the club, skip the queue and go straight to our seats. So we go in the door, there's a queue, we show our tickets to a couple of different staff members and they just said wait in the queue, even they were saying, you know, we've got these tickets, we should be skipping the queue. That never happened. We were just told to stay and wait in the queue, and that took at least 20 minutes or so. And then by the time we'd got through all that mess and we're going up the stairs, I was already really annoyed. I was just feeling really peed off already, because, you know, outside the club, you've got the people dressed up as the, you know, bloody Batman in the mask, and they just pounce on you basically to take bloody pictures and just demanding, you know, money, that's all it's about out there, unfortunately. So I already had a bad taste in my mouth, and then all this fiasco trying to get into the club and get to our seats. The staff member then showing us to our seats expected a tip to put us in a better seat, a better position, even though we were up on the balcony. We should have had a great seat already, but we were shoved way in the back in the dark, there were no lights, by some huge speakers. I literally couldn't hear myself thinking, I know you're in a club, you got to expect that, but you don't expect to be sat next to a bass bin that's bigger than your entire body. And yeah, that was fun. So, you know, a few minutes go by or so, and another guy comes to us and says, you know, he can get us better seats for $120 each. So this is another ridiculous tip on top of what we've already paid. So Shane goes with the guy to see if the seats are any better. And lo and behold, they are not. They are at the front of the balcony, but they are so far back. You're basically in line with the stage and you're just, you know, slightly behind the curtain. So it means you wouldn't see anything at all. So it's completely pointless. So we said, no, sod it, we'll stay where we are, up in the dark corner. And also with the gold member ticket, you're supposed to get table service and food. And I believe it was sliders, fries, and a few other bits and pieces. No one came to our table to serve us. No one even acknowledged that we were there. Shane had to go to the bar himself to get our drinks, and he got a beer. I just had pineapple juice, and it was basically water with a squirt of pineapple juice, and it was rough. So by this point, I'm even more pissed off, and I think I'm one of those people, once I get in a mood, because, you know, things just are not going right, it just doesn't seem or feel right, I can't bring myself out of that, and I'm just sitting there getting more angry and more angry. I just can't enjoy the show. I'd been looking forward to this for so freaking long as well, and I just feel like it was, you know, getting ruined. And it's just getting worse and worse and worse as you know, the minutes go by, literally. So in the end, I think we got to about an hour, and me and Shane just decided, that's it, let's call it a night, let's go home. You know, it was really terrible experience. The staff were all very rude. We didn't get the service that we were supposed to have with the gold membership, so, you know, skipping the queues, a good seat on the balcony, table service with drinks and food included, we got none of that. And we, you know, we were sat there watching other people in the same area get said table service, having food and drinks brought to them. We had nothing. They didn't even come and ask us if we actually wanted anything at all, let alone bring us what we were supposed to have, what we paid for. And yeah, it was just an all-round bad experience. Unfortunately, the tipping culture out there is horrendous. I mean, I know you've got to expect that in anywhere in the Americas, you know, the USA, Canada as well, but in the UK it's not a thing. And to be tipping people for something so petty and pointless, especially when you're getting shit service, it's not worth it at all. So in conclusion, we didn't enjoy Coco Bongo one bit. It was just, it could have been a fun night if the staff were good and we got the correct service that we were supposed to have, but I wouldn't go there, I wouldn't recommend it. So don't even waste your money, go to a little club somewhere else. Just don't bother wasting your time at Coco Bongo. Absolute rip-off merchants. So that's all I've got to say. If you want to ask any more questions about it, ask me below in the comments. I'll do my best to answer. But yeah, thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye.